Hello, welcome in the second devlog about WoodCraft, a new indie game which I am making after hours, in which player will be running own sawmill and will have to carefully manage resources so he can pay the bills. If you haven't seen the first part, I will leave a link to it somewhere at the top. In this part, I wanted to show you how I implemented the mechanics of inventory and containers. Inventory, the basis of almost every game. At first glance, the subject may seem trivial, but upon further reflection, we begin to see the complexity of this topic. For example, should our character be able to put every object in the game into an inventory? If not, how should we tell which objects cannot be collected? Or should the inventory have a limited capacity? If so, what makes it full? The number of objects or perhaps the weight? There are tons of questions, and I've honestly spent many days thinking how the inventory should work in the WoodCraft. The problem is, I want my game to be very detailed and I'm planning to put various different objects in game. There will be a lot of tools like chainsaw, handsaw, lumber cloth, winch, measure tape, or liquids like gasoline, diesel, engine oil, coolant oil, or foods or resources. With this number of items, the inventory UI must be as friendly as possible. At first, I decided to take many ideas from Project Zomboid because the UI created there is perfectly for handling a lot of items. But there is one thing I don't like in PC: container system. It relies entirely on the weight of the objects, which often results in not immersive situation. For example, the game allows us to hide boards in our backpack, which of course will never fit in the backpack. And on the other hand, we will not be able to hide in the backpack small items of high density, like something made of steel. But the common logic tells us that they would easily fit there. So, I decide to design a slightly different system. Basic rules. Every physical object has dimensions and volume. Every object in the game can also be a container. Every container has dimension limit and volume limit. Any physical object that fits with these limitations can be put into that container. This means that one container can be put into another, for example, a box in a locker. I start by creating basic components to describe the objects in the game. Each collectible item will have a physical item component which, as the name implies, specifies what dimensions and mass the object should have. Next, I write a component that will determine the item's ability to be a container. In addition, I create a component called container child, which will be needed for reverse dependency. For example, when some manager will want to check if an object does not belong to some container. The next point, a UI panel that will display the contents of the container. Since I assume that the player can have several containers on him, for example a backpack, pockets in the jacket and so on, I immediately create a panel that supports several containers similar to the one from Zomboid. Then I create a placeholder backpack on the character. I don't know why it reminds me very much of the backpack of a courier delivering food. To run some tests, I still need to create a proper controller, which when I press some key will open UI panel and assign the containers detected on the character to it. Next, I am making a simple controller, which when the mouse button is pressed, casts away, and if it hits some physical item that is within the player's range, it adds to the first magic container. And the last thing which needs to be made, actual items which I will pick up. After that, I have a simple inventory system with multi-container support. The created UI turns out to be very useful also for the next point, which is to show objects in the environment. All I need to do is pass to it a list of objects with a container component found within some range. So I quickly write a simple manager to handle the objects in the environment. I set the variable loop counter to make the scan happen only once per second because I don't want to burn your hardware. Then I add components to the car and the cabinets in the house. I set some random values, for the moment it's not important. Time for the test, and it seems that everything works. Maybe not perfectly, but it works. In general, I want player to carry most stuff in hands. I don't like idea of men cutting trees and wearing backpack. but at this moment my hero can't handle anything. So I decide to create another component called Human, whose task will be to store information about what is carried and check in if item can be taken. Then I set all parameters of the component, including where the item should appear. Okay, everything seems to work correctly. Except that the handling animation does not convince me at all. Not at all. To improve it, I'm exploring the topic of inverse kinematics. I've never used it before, so I'm taking some time for learning. And after the first hour, I give it up and I go out to get some fresh air. Especially since it's finally the first sunny day in several weeks. After break, I realized that for start, I should simply define the points for which object can be grabbed. With that solution, I can adjust the position and rotation in the editor so the hands look natural. The downside of such a solution is that I will have to define handle for each object in game. I'm trying to automate handle point generation based on the dimension of the object. On boxes, it works quite well. But when I use another object like woodblock, which should be carried on the shoulder, the matter gets complicated. So I add handles to the lock by hand and leave that topic for later. I have to remember that this is supposed to be a prototype for now, so it's not about the look but about the mechanics. For now, I need to represent in some way what the player has in hands. It seems to me that probably the fastest way is to create a common iContainer interface, which both the container and the human will implement. With this approach, I can use one and the same component to display the contents of the container. Last but not the least, I decided to unify the way of performing operation on objects. For this purpose, I will use context menu. Context menus are great because they allow you to display different options depending on the selected object. For example, if an object lies next to a car and a box, I can theoretically perform as many as 4 actions on it. Hide it in the trunk, hide it in the box, hide it in the pockets, or take it in the hands. I can dynamically generate all these options in the context menu. So I create a simple prefab UI in which I put a panel where the button will appear. Connecting this menu to the controller is already a bit more challenging because I have to include all the logic here. After adding some initial rules, everything seems to be working properly. I can pull the content I'm interested in from the boxes, or I can put the box themselves in the trunk, which is really great. And that's all for now. I'm really happy with how it's all going forward. I have the mechanisms for operating on the objects ready, so in the next week I will try to implement some mechanics of chopping down trees and making logs. Because after all, this is mainly what the game is supposed to be about. For this, I will have to add some model of chainsaw, a mechanism for burning fuel or preparing the fuel oil mixture, and then there is the tree warning animation itself, a mass of work. But keep your thumbs up for me and see you in the next Devlog.